So, hello students, once again, this is Shashank Sapra and we will be continuing our chapter, that is refraction by spherical lenses. In the previous video, I have described you the spherical lenses and the most important terms related to them, like the principal focus, center of curvature, etc. Right? Now we will head further towards the image formation by spherical lenses. Right, but before the image formation by the lenses, we should be knowing some of the specific rules that are applicable while passing or while following the refraction by spherical lenses. So, for the very first, there are certain rules by the concave lenses. Concave lens, let me tell you, is a diverging kind of lens. So when a light ray parallel to the principal axis strike on concave lens, then after refraction it diverges as it is coming from the focus. Is tarah se ye diverge hoti hai, like it appears to come from the focus. Appears beta kyun bol rahe hain? Because concave lens has a virtual focus that I have described you in the previous video lecture also. Right? Now the rule number second is, if a light ray is directed towards the focus of concave lens, then after refraction it will become parallel to the principal axis. Right? If a incident light ray is directed towards the principal focus, then after refraction it will become parallel to the principal axis. Right? And in the third case, a light ray passing through the optical center of concave lens will pass without any facing any kind of deviation. That means if an incident light ray strikes the concave lens at its optical center, then it will refract undeviatedly. Yeah, it will pass undeviatedly along the same path. Right? Okay. All right. Now let us move to the next page. Over here, the rules for image formation or the rules for refraction by concave lens have been explained. Convex lens, let me tell you, is a converging kind of lens. That means it converges the light rays at a particular point, and that particular point is termed as focus. Right? If a light ray parallel to the principal axis strikes the convex lens, then after refraction it passes through a point on principal axis, that is termed as focus. On the other hand, if a light ray is passing through the principal focus of convex lens, then after refraction it becomes parallel to the principal axis. And in the third case, if a light ray is passing through the optical center, then it will pass straight forward without any deviation. Right? तो यहाँ पर भी तीन रूल्स हैं, रिकॉल कर लेते हैं. कॉन्वेक्स लेंस में इफ अ लाइट रे इज पैरेलल टू द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, देन आफ्टर रिफ्रैक्शन इट विल पास थ्रू द फोकस. If a light ray is already coming from the focus, then after refraction from the convex lens, it will become parallel to the principal axis. And if a light ray is passing through the optical center of convex lens, then after refraction, it will pass undeviatedly along its original pathway. Right? Now over here, we should start the image formation first of all by the convex lens, that is a converging lens. Again, as in the case of mirrors, we had six cases with the concave mirrors. Over here also, in the case of convex lens, यहाँ पर बेटा हमारे six cases होंगे. Mirrors के case में concave mirror के साथ हमने six cases को study किया था, है ना? Let me recall you, the object was placed at infinity, then beyond center of curvature, then at center of curvature. ऐसे ही यहाँ पर भी positions होंगी, and now the positions will be six. And remember, यहाँ पे हम center of curvature को बेटा f2f1 से denote करेंगे. We will be defining center of curvature as 2f1, that is twice the focal length. Okay, so in the very first condition, the object is placed at infinity. You can see the notations are given over here. Position of object is infinity. A infinitely placed object will always send parallel light rays from the to the principal axis, and after refraction they will converge at a point known as focus. Therefore, the image will be formed at the point of intersection of all the refracted light rays, that is at focus. The image will be real and inverted. Why the image is real? Because it is formed behind the lens. Lens ke case mein beta, wo image jo lens ke piche ban rahi hai, that will be real and inverted because it will be upside down. Size will be highly diminished, or we can say a point size image is formed. Right? Now the second case, the object will be now placed at a nearby location. Then infinity से ऑब्जेक्ट को थोड़ा सा पास लाते हैं. लेट अस प्लेस इट एज बियॉन्ड F2. हमने इसे F2 से थोड़ा सा पीछे रख दिया, राइट. आप इसको कंपेयर कर सकते हो बियॉन्ड सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर से. मेरा इसके केस में ये बियॉन्ड सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर हम इसे कहते थे, यहाँ पर हम इसे बियॉन्ड 2F1 कह रहे हैं. सॉरी बाई मिस्टेक आई स्पेल्ड इट एज F2, it is 2F1, right? This is beyond 2F1, right? Now, after on placing the object beyond at the position beyond 2F1, a parallel light ray will pass through the focus, and a light ray coming from the optical center will pass undeviatedly. Both the light rays will be meeting at a point between F2 and 2F2, right? इसको F1 और 2F1 name देते हैं, इसको 2F1 और 2F2 name दिया जाता है, right? This will be 2F. Okay, so the image will be formed between F2 and 2F2 on the other side, and the nature will be real and inverted. As you can see, the image is formed below the principal axis, inverted image hai, and size is diminished. Right? Size beta diminished banega, aap isko smaller than the object bhi define kar sakte ho. You can even write it as smaller than the object. In the next case, we will be placing object as C2, that is, sorry, object as 2F1. This will be mentioned as 2F1 over here. Right, and when the object is placed at 2F1, the image will be formed as 2F2. The case is exactly similar to the center of curvature. Concave mirror में जब हम center of curvature पे object रखते थे, तो mirror के सामने center of curvature पे ही image आती थी. यहाँ पर जब 2F1 पे object रखा है, तो image आपको बेटा 2F2 पे मिल रही है on the other side of lens. क्योंकि image lens के पीछे है, then the image will be real inverted and is will be exactly equal to the size of object. जो साइज होगा ऑब्जेक्ट इमेज का, दैट विल बी इक्वल टू द साइज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, और वी कैन से दैट इट विल बी ऑफ सेम साइज. ओके, लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट इमेज फॉर्मेशन. नाउ वी विल बी प्लेसिंग ऑब्जेक्ट बिटवीन 2F1 एंड F1. ऑब्जेक्ट को हम 2F1 और F1 के बीच में रखेंगे. इन दिस केस द इमेज विल बी फॉर्म्ड, दिस विल बी F2, दिस पॉइंट विल बी 2F2, एंड द इमेज फॉर्म्ड इज बियॉन्ड 2F2, राइट. The image will be formed beyond 2F2. Nature will be real and inverted, and you can see the image size is larger than the object size, so the image size will be enlarged. Right? Simple formations है, rule को follows करना है. Incident, दो incident light rays लेनी है, दोनों का refraction कराना है. जिस point पे refracted light rays intersect कर रहे हैं, that will be your image. Right? Now the next case is, what will happen if the object is placed at F1? Then the image will be formed as infinity. When the object is placed at F1, the image will be at infinity, real inverted, and the size of image will be highly enlarged. Right? And the last but not the least case is, when the object is placed between the, yahan pe, over here the position of object is given wrong. The position of object, let me tell you, is position of object will be between focus and optical center O. Position of object will be between focus and the optical center O. Right? In this condition, this is F1, this is the optical center O, and the object is placed over here between them, then the image will be formed in front of the lens. Yahan par beta image lens ke samne ban rahi hai, and it is larger than the object. Because the image is above the principal axis, that means the image is erect and virtual, size will be enlarged. राइट, पोजिशन ऑफ इमेज इज सेम साइड एज डेट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट. यहाँ से इमेज का क्या मतलब है, दैट जो इमेज है वो उसी साइड बन रही है लेंस के जहाँ पर ऑब्जेक्ट को रखा गया था. दिस इज द ओनली केस वेयर कॉन्वेक्स लेंस फॉर्म्स अ वर्चुअल इमेज. ये अकेला ऐसा केस है बेटा जहाँ पर कॉन्वेक्स लेंस वर्चुअल इमेज बनाता है, जब ऑब्जेक्ट को उसके फोकस और ऑप्टिकल सेंटर के बीच में प्लेस किया जाए. Right, so totally we have considered 6 cases. Let me recall you very fast. The very first case was when the object was placed at infinity. The image was at focus, real inverted, and highly diminished, or a point size image. The second case, when the object was placed beyond 2F2, the image was formed between F2 and 2F2, and the image was formed smaller than the object. Right, real inverted image was formed. Nextly, the object was placed at 2F1 and the image was formed on the other side at 2F2. The size was as that of the object, that is same size image, and the real inverted image was formed. Then finally, in the next ray in the next image formation, the object was placed between 2F1 and F1. The image was formed beyond 2F2 on the other side, and the image was enlarged and real and invert. Right. Finally, when we place the object at focus of the convex lens, the image was formed at infinity, and it was a highly enlarged image along with real and inverted as its nature. Finally, when we place the object between the focus and the optical center between F1 and O, then the image was formed on the same side of lens, that is in front of the lens, and it was characterized as a virtual and erect image which was larger in size than the object. Alright, so this was the image formation by convex lens. Now let us continue with the concave lenses. When we talk about the concave lens, I have already told you concave lenses are diverging kind of lens, right? So first of all, if the object is placed at infinity for a concave lens, the incident light rays are not very clear. Let me show you, right? These are the light rays coming from an infinitely placed object, and after refraction they will appear to diverge from the focus. You can see at the other side of lens, they are never meeting at all because they are moving apart from each other. Lens ke right side mein kabhi bhi meet nahi karengi. Therefore, you will have to produce them backwards. Aapko inhe peeche produce karna hoga, and behind the lens or in front of the lens, they will be meeting at a point known as focus. Therefore, the image will be formed as focus, and the nature of image will be virtual and erect and highly diminished. क्योंकि बेटा इमेज लेंस के सामने ही बन गई है, तो यहाँ पे इमेज कैसी होगी? वर्चुअल होगी और इरेक्ट होगी. इन द नेक्स्ट केस, लेट मी शो यू, व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस्ड एनीवेयर बिटवीन इन्फिनिटी एंड ओ, ऑब्जेक्ट को आप इन्फिनिटी और ऑप्टिकल सेंटर ओ के बीच में कहीं भी आप प्लेस कर सकते हो. इस केस में हम कोई भी स्पेसिफिक पोजिशन नहीं लेंगे. क्यों नहीं लेंगे, दैट ऑल्सो आई विल बी टेलिंग यू. अगर आपने ऑब्जेक्ट को यहाँ पे प्लेस किया इन्फिनिटी और ऑप्टिकल सेंटर ओ के बीच में, देन ऑल्सो इमेज विल बी ऑप्टेन डेट विल बी बिटवीन F1 एंड ऑप्टिकल सेंटर, एंड दैट विल बी स्मॉलर देन दी ऑब्जेक्ट. ये इमेज बेटा अगेन ऑब्जेक्ट से छोटी है, एंड बिकॉज इट इज़ फॉर्म इन फ्रंट ऑफ द लेंस, द इमेज विल बी वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट. यू कैन सी वर्चुअल इरेक्ट इमेज एंड इज डिमिनिश्ड इन साइज, राइट? सो फ्रॉम हियर इट इज़ वेरी क्लियर दैट concave lens always forms a virtual erect image that is diminished in size. एक concave lens हमेशा virtual erect image बनाता है और वो हमेशा size में diminished ही होती है. Like in the case of mirrors बेटा, हमने देखा था convex mirror हमेशा कैसी image बना रहा था? Virtual image बना रहा था और छोटी बना रहा था. यहाँ पर concave lens virtual और छोटी image बना रहा है, right? Let us move to the next topic now. The next topic discussed over here is a very important one. It is actually a mathematical formula that helps us to find out the image distance and the object distance, or it gives us a relation between the image distance, object distance and the focal length of a lens, right? You can use this formula effectively for solving out the numerical problems wherever image distance or the object distance is given and the focal length is to be finded out. Or any of the two quantities out of these three should be given to you, and the third one will be asked, right? So 1 upon f is equals to 1 upon v minus 1 upon u is the lens formula. Recall that in the case of mirrors, 1 upon v plus 1 upon u was the mirror formula. The next thing is magnification. We have also studied magnification in the case of mirrors. Magnification is actually the ratio of height of image to that of height of object, and is represented by a letter small m. Other than this height, the magnification of a image formed by a lens can also be explained in the terms of image distance and the object distance. M is equals to V upon U. From here we get two formulas. M is equals to HI upon HO, that is height of image upon the height of object, and is also equal to V upon U, that is image distance in the upon object distance. राइट, तो यहाँ पे दो रेशियोज़ में हम मैग्नीफिकेशन को एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं. ईदर द रेशियो ऑफ हाइट ऑफ इमेज टू द हाइट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, और द रेशियो ऑफ इमेज डिस्टेंस टू द ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस, राइट? फाइनली वी हैव टू डिस्कस्ड ओवर हियर पावर ऑफ अ लेंस. लेट मी टेल यू, ऑलवेज एंड ऑलवेज When we talk about lenses, we talk about their power. Power of a lens is actually the degree of convergence or the divergence of light rays that can be produced by a particular lens. कोई भी लेंस बेटा किसी पर्टिकुलर लाइट रे को जो उस पर स्ट्राइक करती है उसे कितना कन्वर्ज कर सकता है या कितना डाइवर्ज कर सकता है, ये उसकी पावर पे डिपेंड करता है, या एक्चुअली यही उसकी पावर है कि वो किसी में कितनी लाइट रेज को कितनी डिग्री से कन्वर्ज कर देगा या कितनी डिग्री से डाइवर्ज कर देगा. पावर ऑफ अ लेंस इज डिफाइंड एज अ रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ फोकल लेंथ इन मीटर्स. पावर ऑफ लेंस भी बेटा उसी तरह से डिफाइन किया जाता है जैसा कि है ना. सो पावर ऑफ अ लेंस इज रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ फोकल लेंथ, बट रिमेंबर आपको फोकल लेंथ की वैल्यू हमेशा मीटर्स में ही पुट करनी है. पावर की जो यूनिट है बेटा वो होती है 1 डायोप्टर. डेट मीन्स 1 डायोप्टर इज इक्वल्स टू 1/1 मीटर. इसका मतलब 1 डायोप्टर इज द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ अ लेंस हुज फोकल लेंथ इज 1 मीटर. 1 डायोप्टर उस पावर की, 1 डायोप्टर इज द पावर ऑफ अ लेंस हुज फोकल लेंथ इज 1 मीटर. यू कैन ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंट इट एज 1 डायोप्टर इज इक्वल्स टू 1 मीटर इनवर्स. Right, 1 meter inverse. All right. Power of a convex lens is always positive. ये बेटा कैसे find out होगा? Because the focal length of a convex lens is positive, therefore its power is also positive. When we are talking about convex, when we will be talking about concave, because the focal length of a concave lens is negative. Negative क्यों होती है बेटा कॉनकेव लेंस की फोकल लेंथ? क्योंकि कॉनकेव लेंस का फोकस उसके सामने होता है, दैट इज अपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंसिडेंट रेज, एंड दैट डायरेक्शन इज टेकन एज नेगेटिव. अब क्योंकि फोकल लेंथ नेगेटिव है, देयरफॉर पावर विल आल्सो बी टेकन एज नेगेटिव. पावर को भी नेगेटिव ही कंसीडर किया जाएगा. तो ऑलवेज एंड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, कॉन्वेक्स लेंस हैव अ पॉजिटिव पावर एंड कॉनकेव लेंस हैज अ नेगेटिव पावर. राइट. वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ओवर हियर दैट नीड्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड इज combination of lenses. That is also being discussed in your NCERT book. Let me tell you what combination of lenses mean. Let us just suppose if two lenses are placed in close contact with each other. Right? यहाँ पे दो lenses हैं, पहला concave है और दूसरा convex, और दोनों एक दूसरे के close contact में रखे हुए हैं. Let us just consider that इस concave lens की जो power है वो minus का 3 diopters है, और इस convex lens की power plus का 1.5 diopters है. Wait, let me rub this. Okay, तो बेटा जो कॉनकेव लेंस है इसकी पावर माइनस का 3 diopter, बिकॉज कॉनकेव लेंसेज यूजली हैव अ पावर इन नेगेटिव, एंड जो कॉन्वेक्स लेंस है उसकी पावर प्लस का 1.5 diopter है. तो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ लेंसेज क्या हमें कहता है? वाइल फाइंडिंग आउट द नेट पावर ऑफ अ कॉम्बिनेशन, कभी भी अगर आपको किसी कॉम्बिनेशन की पावर फाइंड आउट करनी है तो यू हैव टू जस्ट ऐड दैम नॉर्मली एज यू डू द एडिशन. आपको उन्हें वैसे ही ऐड करना है जैसा नॉर्मल एडिशन आप करते हो. सो माइनस थ्री प्लस 1.5 विल बी इक्वल टू -1.5. सो इस तरह के कॉम्बिनेशन की जो नेट पावर होगी दैट विल बी -1.5 diopter. तो ये कॉम्बिनेशन एक्चुअली में किस तरह से वर्क करेगा? इट विल बी वर्किंग एज अ कॉन्केव लेंस ऑफ 1.5 diopters. राइट. जब आप बेटा कॉन्केव लेंस बोल देते हो तो आपको पावर में नेगेटिव नहीं बोलना होता, बिकॉज कॉन्केव इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट्स दैट द पावर इज नेगेटिव. सो ईदर यू हैव टू इंडिकेट द साइन और यू हैव टू इंडिकेट द नेचर ऑफ लेंस. ऑल राइट. Okay, so this was all about the explanation of this chapter. Now we have completed the reflection part and the reflection part completely. I hope the content was pretty clear to you and you got each and every point of the content very clearly. Even if someone is facing any kind of problem, you can personally contact me on WhatsApp. I will always be ready and feel good to solve out your doubts and queries. Okay, students, stay safe, stay healthy, and take care of yourselves.